Piano Circus.
Oh, in here, yeah, Mary's Circus.
Yeah, Mary's Big Circus. The, this is the room they were in first. And she said her husband Ray was of no help at all because he was always just sitting here looking out the window to watch trains go by. One thing I do like about sound, really great on this layout, you want to know your train is you push the horn button and it comes. One set of white decals for the Copper River in Utah, which was the late Brian Ellerby's home railroad name. Mm-hmm. And it was SM3. It was Evergreen Stadium. Brian, I don't know.
SM3.
Pardon?
It's SKO.
SKO, different name. But the smallest lettering looked like billboard lettering on an HON310. So, I'm running one train with Cascade Southern on it, which is Wayne Vanguard service. And then I got another one that's going to be Copper River in Yukon. And now I have a third one of that type of locomotive. And I'm thinking about hand lettering it to be Grand Ronde Northern, which was Bill Wardell's letter. I actually had a caboose lettered that, but I think it was.
Oh, look, two trains.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So is Canadian Northern like part of BNSF or something?
Oh, Canadian National? No. The other day I saw something going through here that was BNSF, Union Pacific, and Canadian Pacific. Seeing that down here, it always makes me wonder if it's on a detour. It got something down. Firebrand and Treasure of Johnson Canyon. Hmm. One of these days, Jackass Mountain's going to fall into the Treasure River Canyon, and both railroads and the highway are going to fall. I'm too old to change now. I don't do much of that. Even though a lot of my original stuff is destined for a display show. I
remember it,
compared to today. But then, guy driving a 1954 Ford. I know you're driving a Ford at that point. Becky Weidenberg driving along. If you wanted to light it, you lift your foot off the gas, and then you put your foot back off the gas. A manual tilt. Of course, we're still using it. The button's sticking out of the rear. The switch is on, makes it appropriate. They're all still working, but we haven't replaced a lot. The only electric switch machine on the original railroad was under here. And after only 30 years, unfortunately, a guy had a 30 year